So I'm proud of the EFF. They're not bowing down. They're not listening to emotional people in the social media. People who just listen to the news and believe everything the news say. They're not listening to those people. They're standing on their principles. And me, as a fellow South African young man, I never misinterpreted their position on open border police. I never misinterpreted their position on being pan-Africans, because I understand it's all about being black conscious. It's all about understanding that these white colonizers, these Europeans, they wanted to divide and conquer. And most people are working for them because they would hate a fellow black man who's trying to unite black people. Forget about uniting countries and Africa being one. Forget about that. We're talking about hatred. People are walking around with hate towards a Zimbabwean, a Mozambican. Why? Where does that come from? Did you sit down and actually just out of nowhere hated them? Or somebody planted that hate in your heart, in your head? It was planted in you. You don't internally hate them. You are hating them because somebody convinced you have to hate them. So it's not out of your doing. It's not out of your choice. So you are the emotional one. You are easily emotionally blackmailed. So you are the problem in our society. Because people can just tell you something and you believe it and you walk around with it and you start hating people for no reason. People who have never done anything wrong to you. You're walking around with hatred. Why? Get a life, man. Go do something. Stop that all hatred and hey, foreigners this. It's fine. There is foreigners who open shop and sell fake products. Nobody wants them. Nobody agrees with them. Their shops must be closed. We agree that their shops must be shut down. The police must intervene. We agree. Even the EFF leadership agrees. Nobody agrees with crime. We agree that drug dealers or people who are doing crime, whether foreigners or from South Africa, they must get their day in court and they must get their day behind bars. They must learn a lesson. We agree. Nobody disagree. Us promoting loving other African countries and other African brothers and sisters, it doesn't mean we are condoning crime. It doesn't mean we are condoning drugs. You are missing the whole point. And it shows to me you are lacking something, man, because there's no way you can misinterpret a simple principle like this. There's no way, unless you're not here, you know, with your understanding levels. You are still below there, you know. You are still playing with grade R type of understanding levels. You need to grow up, man. You need to be mentally resilient. You need to think for yourself. You need to do your own research and actually understand things for yourself. Don't wait for other people to try and interpret things on your behalf or to try and interpret things for you.